Please, Maestro. Nice to see you.
Thank you. Well, it's very nice to see you here too, and we hope we can add a little to your holiday spirit today. Feel free to tap along or hum along, but just watch out for our little transitions. We may fool you by time.
Activities. Among them was she belonged to the lawn bowling club here. She sang in the choir. She played cello with us in this orchestra and also played Tuesday night group. The three groups have gotten together and made a monetary contribution to the Conservatory of Performing Arts. In Helen's name, a violin has been repaid and is on loan to the children who are in need. Helen Dorman was a musician. She played the cello and she sat up right over there for many, many years. For Helen, playing the cello was a simple gift. She loved it. And I like to think that Helen
today, and she's listening, and she's watching. So, Helen, this is for you, Simple Gifts.
Presenting Hansel and Gretel on New Year's Day. And for those of you who don't know about it, there is a live broadcast that is held at the Empire Theater in Park Lane of that production. So this is the one that the Metropolitan Opera chose, and we decided it'd be a good idea for us to do part of it too. So these are some selections from Hansel and Gretel.
Thank you.
stolen, and the choir has shrunk a little, so kind of in your laps today.
Oh,
next piece. Oh, you're featuring one of the members of our choir. This is Joan Maywood. And she's going to do some solo parts in I'll Be Seeing You.
Thank you.
childhood days. This was Perry Como that sang.
Yeah. and a visit. That the orchestra does in between each, so just watch. I always tell my groups, the reason why you have to watch a conductor so closely is because you can never trust them. have that for lunch.
So now we're going to go back in time a little bit.
18th century.
And Mozart's a playwright. There are many, many playwrights out there. Of course, the Leroy Anderson one is a very popular one. But the Mozart one is very often played, too. And we have to remember, in those days, there was no electricity, no computers, no telephones. The fastest thing was a horse. You're going to see Phyllis leave very quickly when we finish. Snow is predicted. She drives down from Amherst. So we have certainly very, very dedicated people in this group. And I'll take this opportunity to thank you for coming out. We're nearly finished with the program, but for coming out to support us. Thank you.
Thank you.
She's going to make you work a little more.
Onward through the night, forward. have a special feature for you.
Before I start this, I just want to say that it wasn't my idea to do this. I was coerced and everything. And I'm just hoping that this piece wasn't selected for me because of my books. Because if it is, I'm taking it up with the human rights. You think this is water, but it isn't. As the director says, ready.
Thank you. Thank you.
Friends of Matt.
There's a great cover on the table that fell down, and they think something fell out of the pocket. I think it was the button hitting the table, but nevertheless, check your pockets, whoever owns that coat. I guess I have to ask you to pick up your chairs and lunch. There's so much food, we couldn't put it out, so we're going to ask you to get your tea here and go around to the kitchen, pick up your lunch, and on behalf of the executive of the Leisure Club, have a wonderful Christmas and a wonderful New Year.